Morning. It was a little dark last night when I finished getting cam set up. I couldn't do any recording, but I took those stakes out already so that I could get into what I had stored in the boat. But this was where I slept. Relaxing, nice night. There's quite a bit of garbage around this campsite. There's not really anything here. You can camp here and it's a boat ramp, but that's really just it. The only development is the road coming in. There's a couple little trails that go back there. I don't know where they go. And then this concrete boat ramp, which after paddling 30 plus miles in a 12-hour day, it was a little tiring bringing everything up. I had to unload everything from the boat because I wasn't dragging it on that. And then pick it up and carry it up the hill and then just kind of drop it down on the grass, and then I could drag it on the grass and the dirt. But look at this view. Look at this. I don't know if that fog will still be there when I actually hit the river. Probably not. I still have to have breakfast, take down camp, get everything down and loaded up. It might be a while. I only have to go about 26 miles to get to Big Shoals today though, so that's a plus. Not as far as yesterday. And there shouldn't be any portages until Big Shoals. Shouldn't be, fingers crossed. The last time I said something like that, I ended up with two more. Yeah. Good trip so far. Thought I would never leave Georgia, but here I am, back in Florida. Day three, baby. Day three. All right, it is 9:30. I'm finally getting started for the day. Packing up camp and packing the boat back up took a little bit longer than I wanted it to, but it's okay. Today should be just paddling. I shouldn't have a portage until Big Shoals. And that's where I'm stopping. So shouldn't have a portage until I stop for the day. Hopefully. The way things have been going, I am cautiously optimistic, we'll put it that way. Alright. Let's go. The only way out is through.
rock. Got some little shoals here.
Jesus Christ. That's a rock.
Okay. Oh man. Woo.
That was exciting. Stop one done, just leaving Cypress Creek, the Cypress Creek launch right now. Make a great campsite. You can tell where someone recently built a fire, and then there's another little spot where there's some stones in a circle for a little fire pit. So keep that one in the back of your mind. That was to me, not necessarily to you. But got about 19 miles left. It is 12:24, so the next few hours might be a little rough with the heat. So we're just gonna take a nice easy pace. There has not been any portages, thank God. I did get a later start today by like an hour and a half, and still almost covered about the same amount of distance that I covered yesterday by this time. Oh, no, that's not fair. I was a little further. Yep, about 19 miles till Big Shoals. I'm going to look for a place to get out and stretch my legs in about 10 miles from now. There's nothing marked on the map before Big Shoals, as far as like a boat launch or anything like that. I know there's a portage trail at Big Shoals, and there's a campsite there, and that's where I'm camping tonight. So, yeah, it's just going to be keep an eye on the distance that I've covered at about 10 miles from now. So it'll be about 17 miles on the day. See if I can find a nice little beach area to get out, stretch my legs, stretch in general, and just, yeah, get in some shade or something. But, yeah, Georgia is, the Georgia section is gorgeous. Very wild. It's obvious people don't maintain it, as observed by the plethora of trees that were blocking passage on the river. But there's like nobody there. I still haven't seen, other than stopping off at Dollar General so that I could get some, get a spoon. I haven't seen another person. So I've seen no one else on the river. I mean, I've passed under a bridge and I've seen people driving over the bridge, but that doesn't count. But yeah, since leaving yesterday, there was one other boat pulling in when I was launching. Yeah, but since then, no one. Still very scenic here too. Not a lot of development. Did see one elevated wooden house a couple miles back. That was it. That's the only house I've seen so far. And I'm pushing like 49 or 50 miles so far in the trip. And I've only gone under two roads. There's the one at Fargo and then the one here. That's it. And then a railroad track. It's gorgeous. Gorgeous.
that goes,
but that is definitely a spring.
There's a boat ramp here at Cone Bridge that I did not mark on my map. That I'm going to mark on my map for if I do this, when I do this again. I'll make sure I add all the, because I know there's some other boat ramps that I have not added, I have not put on. I'll have to go back and add those. But yeah, I've got about 10 miles left. before I get to Big Shoals, and it is 4:03. So I'm thinking maybe 3 hours to get there, a little over 3 hours. Hopefully off the river by 6:30. And first people I've seen since putting on were here. A gentleman, and I'm assuming they were his grandsons, went on a little fishing trip. They caught a pretty decent sized bass. All right, I'm gonna stop talking and I'm gonna start paddling. Big Shoals. Here's the launch above Big Shoals. Should be about a mile from here, maybe less than a mile from here. But the Portage Trail is on River Right. I can hear them. They're right there. Right there. I think that's them. No, I think they're a little further down. Can't see them from here. I can hear them, but I can't see them. But they are definitely that way. I know there's a campsite that overlooks them, so we'll find that. Either way, I'm gonna be camping within earshot of this. It's gonna be nice and relaxing. right, let's take a look at this portage trail. Figure out how I'm gonna do this. I'll be back. Gonna be the hardest part here. Fucking pull everything out. So it's dark. I got the portage done. Wasn't too bad once I got over that that rock ledge, but then it was a drag to get here. I don't know if you can hear the shoals in the background, but I'm on an overlook. I'll get a good shot of it in the morning. I'm pooped. Camp's set up. Now we just gotta get something to eat, go to sleep, and then not break my neck in the morning getting back down to the river. Good morning. I slept amazing. So now that it's light, you can see there's my setup, and
This is my view. Big shoals right there. Listening to the sound of running water all night. Alright. Yeah, I need to get going because I've got 34 miles planned ahead today. The goal is to get to Holton Creek, the river camp. So I'm going to stop talking and get everything packed up and let's get out of here. Finagle our way out of here. So I'm sitting on my fucking hydro flask.
Go. Thank you. All right, time to watch me get stuck on some more rocks. Yep. So, I'm down to only two GoPro batteries because of reasons. So I'm gonna be a little bit more sparing with some of the footage, maybe. I think I have a way to kind of charge one while the other one's in use. We'll see how well that goes. But the plan for today, because I actually launched shortly after 8, is to get as many miles in the morning when it's nice and cool as I can. I do want to stop and see the White Sulfur Springs building because I didn't the last time I was through here. And then once I pass that, then I'll hit Woods Ferry. I'm not planning on stopping at Woods Ferry. But then once I hit Woods Ferry, it's 18 miles until Holton Creek, and that's where I'm shooting for. So once I hit the White Springs ramp, it's 12 to Woods Ferry, and then 18 to Holton Creek. It's gonna be a 34-mile day. So I'm gonna get as many miles in the morning as I can, doing this pace right here, and do this all day. And then have a nice relaxing evening at Holton Creek, the equivalent of luxury accommodations on the river. I don't expect there's going to be any, if any, many people there, which means I should be able to get a pavilion, which will have a fan, and screened in. Means there's less stuff that I'm putting up, which means there's less stuff that I have to take down in the morning, which means that I can get on the river faster. And then I'm only doing the 28 to Dowling Park like I did the last time I was here. But I am pushing 70 miles on the trip so far. That's 25 less than my longest one, which was out here last year, which means by the end of the day today, I will have covered my longest distance in one trip. And it is only day 4. And I still have a good chunk of the last Suwannee trip I did, which was 95 miles. Well, the only way off this river is my car in Suwannee at the Gulf. So, the only way out is for me. Let's go.
Oh,
launched last time, because here is the Suwannee River Wayside Park.
Where I launched from last time. So different from the last time I was out. This little overhang here, that overhang was underwater. I didn't even know it was there. It's crazy. It looks like a completely different river. Pretty cool. All right, leaving the white sulfur spring house. And in case you are wondering, yes, it is aptly named. It definitely smells like sulfur. All right, I've got about
10 miles to Woods Ferry. It's about 10:40 right now. I should be able to be there in the 12 o'clock hour. So maybe like 12:15, 12:30, which is good because then from there it's only 18 miles to Holton Creek. And I will have already done half the day. Half the day from Woods Ferry. You're not gonna watch me struggle to put my spray skirt on. Creek. Damn, that's just pumping.
Holy crap.
Water's a little low. Here's Woods Ferry. Plan to get to Holton Creek didn't happen. Stopped here at Woods Ferry, came up for a stretch, used the restroom, filled up my water, got back down to the boat, was eating some lunch, eating my jerky, and then the thunder starts. After being stupid couple of days ago trying to get out of Georgia, I decided to do the smart thing. I was here. It was 18 miles. I was looking at 6 hours to get to Holton Creek, and I'm already tired. So I decided to go ahead and stay here. I'll do the 18 miles to Holton Creek tomorrow and then pick back up the 28 to 30 miles a day after that. And then but I think my body will appreciate the extra rest, both today and tomorrow, because it's only 18 miles. So I should be done. And I did 17.9, 17.7, so it was almost 18 miles today. So do the other 18 tomorrow, get back on track. And then, yeah, barring any other unforeseen events, that should be that. Good times.